Hey, we've got people here now. You can see the link. Can you type in the chat? Click on group chat. Can you type on the chat? Is that possible? I've never tried the on-air hangouts. Do, 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 do. Anyone in here right now? Should I just be talking to random people? I don't know. If you click on the top left, I think there's like a chat thing. You can see the if you double click on the left uppermost left button, there's a blue box for chat or Q&A, I guess. What's this one? Feature is disabled. Wah, 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 I guess I only see myself here. I see there's six viewers, but I don't really see if anyone's chatting. Can anybody chat so we can see your questions? I'm hearing it ding a bunch. Oh, that's probably people talking somewhere that I can't see. Share chat, group chat. Hello, that's what I put. Links, YouTube page. Let's see if that actually put something somewhere. Sony, just want to tell me how to access the things that you're sending, like the messages you're sending. Put it in the Reddit links. That's so stupid. I don't know why it's not showing up for me. To 12 viewers, so that's better than last time for sure. This sucks. Can't see people chatting. Don't know why it keeps digging in my ears. Oh, there it is. Hey. Pop this out into a window so we can see what's going on. John is my name. Yep. Okay. Take a break. You could restart this Hangouts as an on-air broadcast since its call is limited to so many people. Someone could take my spot. He's starting to check Reddit for the new link. There it is. Someone just posted the new link. I wonder if he realized it would get so big. Hello, everyone. Hey, just a question to the Redditors here. Would you guys download a Google Chrome extension to make Reddit a bit more easy to read? Blah, blah, blah. Is it weird that I can't full screen the stream? Maybe I can. Maroon shirt guy. Okay. Hey. Can you read this? Yeah, awesome. So now we've got the people. Everybody can come in to see. 17, that's awesome. Thanks, guys. Thanks for being so patient. We'll get back to where we were here. So instead of waste your time, I'm just going to go back and up with the previous project that I had, and we'll make sure that is actually working first. So let me just close this project and open up the crib one that I was playing. He cannot, he's lying. They're true Reddit. Crib. So we'll choose this one. And let's just run this spec, I think it's spec dot or something like that. So we'll do cd crib. Would you rather we speak and chat on the YouTube video link? Now this is great to speak here. I can read this. Great. So let's do spec dot, maybe break spec. So let's do R spec run all tests. R spec, there we go. Boom. Okay. So load. Can it load such file? And that's in what file that the error is in. RSpec configuration.rb. Well, that sucks. Let's see, gem list. RSpec 3. Okay, so let's start up with a new getting RSpec to work, because I think it's pretty important to show you guys how to test this code while we go through it. So let's go through and just make a new project and get RSpec to go. So let's see where we can do RSpec Rails is what we really want. We want to just do RSpec info home. Testing tool, programming language, gem install RSpec. So getting started, gem install RSpec. So if we require bowling spec.rb for bowling, describe class bowling score, expresses some basic desired behavior. RSpec bowling spec.rb. So let's just try one file. So let's go to RSpec, and we'll say it's in spec, I think is the folder. Test slash card spec.rb. There, awesome. So the dots mean it runs successful tests. So now let's just do RSpec test and then star maybe. Undefined matches for have four cards. Okay, we're at least in the right place though. So what we need to do now is let's just minimize this stuff. But I think we should be able to make a file. Let's just for fun, let's just make a new file here. So let's do cd and we'll do touch spec.rb, and we're going to do, let's open that file up with the text editor. So we'll say adamspec.rb, just to bring this guy up, and we'll copy over an old spec. Something like this guy. Copy this file, because I think what we should be able to do is go in and just like add this to the file. So this is just a class that has required game.rb, so we need a file that has game.rb. That's the other crappy part. So we'll need to make a new file inside of here. So we'll go add file, call it game.rb, and we'll do class game. And let's see, that goes like that. So all we need to run now is that command we had in here. So let's run rspec, and we'll do spec.rb. Let's see what happens. No examples found. Okay. Took me 10 minutes to find this chat room. Sorry about that. Click the link for the stream. And it's hiding things really quickly. I haven't really used this Hangouts on air very much, but video call from Pradic. Sure. No, too late. So is this everyone work? Is it working for everybody right now? Like everything's okay? You can see the code. You can hear me talk. Can I just get confirmation of that before I talk for like the next hour? Everybody good? You can all see what's going on here. I think people are typing. Honestly, I just don't know anything about Ruby. That's okay. There's nothing you need to know about Ruby. It's a pretty simple language, and I'll get into that. We're going to do like a little project here. But yeah, so anyway, I ran the RSpec file, and that's working properly as it should now. So now let's go into here, and we're going to make a new file. So let's go into, instead of encoder, we've got our lib file, which has all our crib stuff. So I'm just going to rename this to, well, I probably have a bunch of weird things, but let's try it. Let's try refactor, rename. Lib, we'll call that the crib game. Just because I'm going to reuse some of these files. So let's make a new directory, and we'll call it poker. Okay. And inside of here, we've got, game, deck, and so I guess the deck is already there, and it has all the cards that are inside of it. Can't read the code because it's too tiny. Let me see if I can change that. File preferences. See if I can just change the font size. Try Zoom, maybe. Oh, Mac help. Good old Mac help. View. Let's see in preferences, I think. Editor. Let me change the editor, I don't think. CMD and scrolling, good idea. Negative. Apple, yeah, we're on an Apple computer, so. There, as an enter presentation mode. Ooh, look at that. Everybody happy now? Ooh. Okay. People are happy. Let's just hope they're happy. So, what we need to go into, this is our class here, and we just made a new thing that was a new folder. So let's try, it is similar to Python. So this doesn't look very good on the side, but whatever. So inside of here, we're going to make a new file, and we're going to call it poker.rb. So let's just do class poker, and then we're going to do def, let's say foo, and we'll say puts, I'm a poker game. Cool. Save that. And then we're going to go to terminal. There we go. That's what I'll do. Now let's make this bigger so everybody can see. So we'll do view. Bigger. There we go. Mac plus. Where the heck is my plus key on this keyboard? There! I can do other things. I mean, it doesn't really matter. It doesn't matter what language you choose. Like, to be a decent developer in the future, you have to realize that the language doesn't really make a difference. It's the principles you learn inside the language that really make it important. So if you learn one language, yeah, you can apply them across languages. It doesn't really matter. Okay, so now we're in here. Let's do cd crib. So inside of here, I think we have a file that is poker, so we'll do cd poker. So here is our poker.rb, so we're going to run that. So ruby, and we'll say, actually we have to do irb, actually. IRB is interactive ruby, so we'll say irb, and we'll say load poker.rb. So it loaded it up. Now we're going to say p equals, poker.new. So that makes a new class of poker, and we'll say p.foo. And it says, I'm a poker game. So now we're back up and ready to go. So we've got our poker class. There it is. It really does nothing, but that's okay for now. So now let's make a test. Let's just test this foo method, just to get our basic thing working. So we'll say we'll return the number 1. So now if I run this, I'll go back to here and say reload the file, and I'll do like a new poker class, and then I'll do the method, and it returns 1. So let's test to make sure that happens. So what we're going to do now is in our poker folder here, let's make a new folder on this guy. Call it poker test. Okay, and inside of here, we're going to, I think they're called like something underscore spec, yeah. So say new file, poker spec.rb. There we go. So inside of this file, let's just grab what the other one was. I think all it has to do is require and then describe. So it's before block and then a regular block. So let's just grab this guy and go back to here. This should be poker spec. So we're going to describe poker. And we need to require poker slash poker.rb, because that's where that file is located. So describe poker, and we have like a before block. So let's just put a puts happens once. And then it's going to say we need an end block here. And that closes that one, but we need another end block. So end is just the same as brackets in other languages. I missed a video call. Can only guess that people are still in here. It says 25 at the top, so yeah. Let's just leave it for now. So inside of here, I need to expect something to equal 10. So first I'm going to do is describe card, and I'm going to take the foo one, because that's the name of our, so let's go poker.rb in poker spec. So poker.rb has foo, which returns 1, so I'll expect to equal 1. So let's expect, we're going to have to make a poker instance up here. So say at poker equals poker.new. And we'll say expect at poker.foo to equal 1. Like that. Yeah, so I guess like people are trying to call me like a bunch right now, so I'm guessing that we're limited or something, or people don't know how to join. Kyle, would you mind posting something inside of the Reddit thing to say how to join this so that people can actually get into the chat? Like, just give them a little description of how to do it. That'd be really helpful if you could do that. So here I'm going to describe the foo method, and I want to say it, let's just say, returns a value of 1. So I'd expect poker.foo to equal 1. So let's run the test. First off, let's run it and check to see if it equals 2. So if we go back to our this guy here, we should then be able to write, we'll quit this file, and now we need to do is rspec, and we'll do, I'm in poker, I need to go back up a directory, cd dot, so ls, so we've got cd poker, ls inside there. Oh, I'm not in crib anymore. That's right, I changed it over because I wanted to get those card classes. So cd crib, and now we'll do ls. So that has a poker test. There we go. So we're going to do rspec. Well, we'll just do cd and do poker test. Ls, so we get the one there. So let's do rspec. And we'll do poker spec.rb. So, cannot load such file, poker.rb. So let's go back in and see what's wrong there. Poker.rb. So it doesn't like that method. So let's just try poker.rb. poker.rb. Let's try that. Doesn't like that file, basically. Cannot list such file, poker.rb. So, I'm guessing what we're going to need to do... Holy frig, this is messed up. There we go. I think what we need to do is to say, to require that file above. So we get files in crib, so card spec requires card.rb, which is just inside of here. So let's run card spec and see what happens. So we'll do cd test. We'll do rspec cards spec. So we'll do cd dot dot, and then we'll do rspec cardspec.rb. Can't find that, so I'll have to do test. Can't load files. Can't find the files that I'm looking for. Why is that? Let's see. In require. Let's try instead load. Cannot load such file card.rb. Any suggestions? So poker spec loads poker.rb. Maybe like this. Poker specs, we're going to say poker, I think it's underscore test. Now such file, poker. Ugh, that's annoying. cannot load those files. Well, let's just try putting this in here. So poker spec is in the same thing as poker. So all I'm gonna have to do is go in here. So we're gonna have to run is poker/poker spec. Let's try that. Huh. .rb. Well, frig. That sucks. What is going on here? So let's see what they're doing here. Require bowling, class bowling. So that's what we should have, require poker. Right? Yeah, this is crazy. I'm definitely going to switch to Twitch TV. Stupid! Why can I not see the comments? Let's see what people are saying here. So I've lost it all. There it is, finally. Twenty-eight, yeah, that's stupid. There we go. Weird. Okay, so back to what I was trying to do. So I'm trying to require this file so that I can actually run a test. And I'm not able to run that test yet. So it's saying that cannot load such file, so poker.rb. So let's just make sure that's the same, because right now I'm saying poker. So I'll save these files, and I will, so I'm in rspec poker/poker spec.rb. So let's see. It's saying that it can't load it up. It can't find that file. But why is that? Because we've got poker right here. So that poker class, if I hold Mac and click on it, takes me to this class here. Let's just check back to here, and let's look at what we had for the RSpec info. So the class is just a dummy class. Hit, yep, So that is bolin.rb. And then we've got bolinspector.rb, which requires bolin, just like we have. Run the example rstrict bolin instructor.rb. Run the example. Watch it fail. Initial constant bolin. Oh, now write just enough to make it pass. So it writes the pass, and then run rspec bolin spec.rb. bolin spec.rb. One example finished. So we've got a poker class that just has def foo inside of it. And then in poker spec, we've got describe card. Oh. That might be it. I don't think so, though. Describe foo returns a value of 1. So that's it. We're inside of this directory. So if I switch to the poker directory, that should friggin' work. So cd poker ls. I've got the two files here. And our rspec pokerspec.rb. Dang it. Let's just see. Cannot load such file. Just Google this and see. I know it's because I can't find the file somewhere, but rspec. Drop the leading slash in the file name. Try bundle exec, maybe? Little install. Oh, that might be it. Yeah, we can do that. Python and Ruby are very similar, like they're within, like they're so close. Gem install bundler, let's try this. So grab the bundle gem. And we'll say bundle install. Because there's no gem file. Gem install rspec. Sudo, I forgot. Gem install. Sweet. Okay, let's try this again. Needs me in a folder called spec. Oh, that might be it. That might be it, actually. Load card, poker spec. So main language, Ruby on Rails. That's what I've been doing for the last like year and a half, I'd say. But C# I've been doing otherwise, and I've done a little bit of Python and lots of things. Yeah. So let's try this again. So now I put it inside the spec folder. Let's try this. Try rspec. Crib poker spec. Cannot load such file. So let's say rspec Oh, we're in the wrong direction now. Let's say cd dot dot ls, so poker in spec. So let's go rspec spec card spec, the load in card spec. Oh yeah. So it doesn't like this load, it's require. Game.rb, card spec.rb, this needs to be poker.rb. Because I did have this working before. Cannot list such file card.rb. So even that one's failing. But I thought we had it working before, like we saw some tests run. Let's do this. Let's get card spec and let's just undo what we did. So it's just require card.rb. And inside of here, we're going to do. So we can't find card spec, so we need spec card spec. Cannot load such file. Oh, what the F? Hello.rb file. Lib to the load path. That's it. So because I changed this from poker, I need to just rename this to lib. That's kind of stupid. So now that I have this for poker, and I'm also going to need my crib classes inside of there. So I can delete this guy. And encoder, I can put this inside here because we worked on that yesterday. So I'll just delete this. Delete. There's lib. Poker test, we don't need anymore, so let's get rid of that. So now I got lib and spec. And this is how the game runs. Okay, so now let's try this. So now I should be able to run. RSpec spec, I think. It should run all my tests. Okay, now we hit a test. Awesome. Start with a new hand each round string. Okay. So that's fine. So now what we need to do is run spec, and we'll do poker spec.rb. Require. Now switch about lib.rb. What? What the heck did I say that? Right there. Poker.rb. Yes! Haha! We're here. It worked. That's awesome. Oh, that took a long time. So what did we learn? Well, basically, if you're going to use RSpec, you have to have things named lib and spec if you're in a Ruby project, which to me is really, really dumb. But I guess inside of lib, you could have all of your folders and stuff that you want to arrange everything, and spec, you could have just the regular game specs. So, yeah, I can see that now. That makes perfect sense. Okay, so now that we know this actually works, let's extract it to its own game. Because this is too much. This is the crib game, right? So let's go to the poker game. So now let's do a cd poker. There we go. And we'll do ls in here. Lib and spec. Okay, that's why I did it before. For some reason, I don't know why that's different than it is now. So let's just open up the directory and just change those around. So inside of poker, I've got these two files, which I'm going to delete. Start fresh. With the ones that I just made. So let's go to crib, And inside of here, we've got a lib file, which is going to be poker.rb. So we're just going to drag this one down to be inside of poker lib. And then for the spec, it's going to be poker spec. Draw this down to the spec file. So there's poker spec in poker, inside of poker. So now in here, we'll need to do ls again. It's got those things. You can do ls-al. No, it won't show me the directories that are down inside of them. So now let's do that rspec command. Specs, poker spec. There, awesome. We're in our own project. Give me 2 seconds. I'll be right back. And I'm just going to head to the washroom, and I'll come back in 2 seconds. And I'll put up my thing here in the meantime.
Yeah, sure.
Okay. And we're back. All right. So, yeah, follow me on Twitter, at O'Donnell Carl. And I'm looking for remote work. So if you're looking for a remote developer, let me know. So back to here. So we ran our test, and we got the F letter here, which means there was a failure. And it's expecting 2 and got 1. So let's just finish what we're doing, and then I'll answer some other questions. So back to here. Now we can close this project. You can have some pot level 2. How do we exit presentation mode? Mac, comma, let's try. Exit presentation. Okay, let's add a shortcut for this. Let's make it Control F10. Apply. Okay, Control F10. Boom, there we go. All right, so we're going to close this project and open up directory, which is going to be poker. Okay. We are now ready to actually do some programming on poker. Hallelujah. So, it's a presentation mode that everybody wants to see. Mac 1, awesome. All right. So, now we've got this poker class, and we've got the specs, so all we have to do is change it to equal 1. That's what we want poker.foo to do, is change it to equal 1. Then we can hit our test again, and it'll pass. So, dot means it passed, and it finished in less than a little, you know, not very much. It didn't take much time to do. So, that was one example, zero failures. We're going to keep going on this because it's a nice little object-oriented design that we'll work on. But you ask, what is Ajax? That is easily Googleable, but basically it's a way to post things back in HTML and not have to resend the entire page, but just send snippets of HTML. So every time you click on a page in a browser, it basically reloads the HTML from the server. So it makes a request and reloads the entire page. You can make it so it doesn't have to do that each time, which is really useful for front-end programming. So inside of poker, what's poker going to actually do? This will be, let's make a poker, which is a new game, right? So inside of new game, it is going to... Yeah, it doesn't take that long to build and set up. It's just because I was confused. That was the only reason. So the way the IDE is set up is basically nothing. It's just a text editor, right? So this IDE is RubyMine from JetBrains, and it just has two files inside of it. The problem is it wasn't named lib and spec, and I was trying to use rspec, and that it forces you to have lib and spec as the directory names. That's why I couldn't find anything in the Rails configuration file. So now that we're back up to where we should be, I mean, it's no big deal at all. We can run the tests, and we can see the code and everything like that. So it shouldn't be too bad. So inside of this file, we're going to need to run this game. So a new game will be, you'll need to deal out cards. Right now we have to actually go through and implement this. So poker is going to have the whole game, and the game should have two users. Let's see. I think first let's maybe start with a different class. So let's open up a new file, and we'll make it card.rb. Let's actually call it deck.rb. So inside of deck.rb, it's the same sort of deal, just a class deck end. So we'll say class deck end, and we'll add a test for this guy too, new file, and we'll call it deck underscore, whoops, dot rb. And this is going to be the same thing. So it's going to require the class that we have, and we'll just set it up basic. Let's just copy the whole thing. Just, I don't really like to copy and paste code that much, but just for speed here. So we'll say a deck dot rb and describe the deck class. And before each deck, we're going to do nothing right now, and we're going to describe the deck, and we'll call that this method deal. Okay, so inside of the deck method, we need to do a method called def deal. Tab in there. So to deal with this one, we need a list of cards. So let's put a variable up here that's the at cards. In fact, we'll just store these in a method, I guess. So we'll say def cards, and we're going to just store what's inside there. And I think I already have this written out, so let's just find it. Just so I don't write it again. What does that open it in? Xcode? It's not really what we want, but hey, it's not that bad. So that's the with text edit. Let's just do that one. So there we are, fresh deck. So here's a fresh deck of cards. So it sets the variable, but all we really need, we actually do need to have a global variable up here, or like a static variable. So let's say, let's call it fresh deck equals an array of nothing. And the reason being is that as we subtract and add to these cards, we're going to have to make a new deck each time. So we'll say def, we'll call this one shuffle cards, we'll say def shuffle, like that. So basically what we're saying is that every time we shuffle the cards, we'll get all the cards again. So there's all the cards written out from before, King of Diamonds, everything like that. So shuffle the cards. So inside of deck spec, we're going to describe shuffle. And it should have a fresh deck of 52 cards. So inside of here, we're going to say, up here, we'll say at deck equals deck.new. So we'll just make a new deck there. And so instead of here, we'll say at deck. You have to use at because that makes it a variable available between the before and after, the before and regular describe one. So we'll say at deck dot shuffle and dot. Now we're going to have to get the cards that are in the deck. So this deck method, this is going to shuffle, and then we'll need a thing that says def cards. I don't know what we're going to call it quite yet. We'll probably have to call it shuffle it after each round is done. So we'll say that before we do that, let's just say def cards is equal to fresh deck. Okay. So it doesn't really like this. Let's see if we can class variable usage. Let's just see if we can do at fresh deck, which most people prefer. So yeah. So inside of here, we're going to do deck.shuffle. And once we've done a deck.shuffle, it should return the deck object itself. But we'll just do the shuffle first, and then we'll say at deck.cards. So we'll do expect here. So let's just check that to poker spec. Expect poker.foo to equal 1. Let's go back here. Expect this to equal 52. So dot cards dot count. Let's try that. Does that make sense? So every time we shuffle, if you do a deck.shuffle, you expect the deck's cards count to be 52. And I think it's EQ. Yep, that's fine. All right, let's give this a try. So now let's run our spec. And I think I can just say rspec spec. Okay. Uninitialized constant deck card. Okay. That's because inside of our deck class, we've got a new card inside each of these, which a card has like a letter and a suit. So a suit and a value. So let's just bring the card class in from my other project, since it's so quick to do so. So we're going to go to here and card class. So we're just going to option click to drag this one down and add it to the poker lib. So there's the card. Anything else we need right now? Player. The rest can be done. I think that's fine. So now if I go back into here, I've got my card class. We'll have to test this guy as well. So let's do, we're getting a little bit too deep. So we'll put this in here for now. Say card spec.rb. We'll just leave it blank for now. So in card.rb, what it actually does is says a suit, a number, and a display value. So it has a def value here, and it has an initialized method that basically puts in the number and the suit. So now we have our deck, which has all these cards inside of it, card.new. And inside of our deck spec, this is what we're testing right now, 52. So let's try it. So, deck shuffle should have a fresh deck victory card. It's failure, error, deck dot shuffle. Another source constant, deck card. An initialized constant, deck card. Oh, it's because it needs to require card inside of the deck class. I think this is going to have to require card. Oops. Try that. There we go. Sweet. So it passed. One of them passed, and it says happens once. I forgot to take that out of the other one. That printed this, basically. So we'll kill this. And it says expected poker.foo to equal 1. So basically, we got rid of the foo method, undefined method foo for poker. Let's go back to here. So now we're in poker, and we've got def new game. So poker spec, it no longer makes sense to have this. So I'll just say new game. And poker dot whatever, so we have nothing to test here right now. And then let's run our tests. Sweet! So they both passed. Everybody follow me so far? Any questions up to this point? Anybody still here? We're good? Everybody can hear? We'll never know. Whatever. Okay. So, got my poker card, I've got my deck, so I've shuffled a new deck of cards. So this shuffle should return self, which I think it does automatically. So, yeah, cool. It does return that automatically? Cool, I'm sure it does. So now if I deal these cards, I need to do shuffle. So if you deal a new deck of cards, you're going to have to shuffle. And then we have to pass cards to each player, right? Okay. So to deal, we have to shuffle, and then we're going to say, like, player. We're in the deck class, right? So deal is just going to shuffle them. So really, the deck is kind of different. So I would say take the deal out of there, right? Because we have to have a class called game, which is kind of like poker. Yeah, I think I'm going to rename poker to game.rp. So I have to rename the spec as well. This might make it a little more clear. Describe game. Look at that. Did everything for me. So inside of game, we're going to make a new game. So what it needs to do is make player one, right, equals, so it's going to have player one, it's going to have player two, it's going to have a deck of cards, and that's it. That's all it should have to have. And inside of here, it's also going to have to count the scores. So, player one equals new, well, player one is going to be a player. And we'll give him a name. So we'll pass in Bill is the first guy. And player dot new, pass in Laura. So, it's going to make a new player of those names every time, over and over, right? So in this game spec, for new game, so it creates two players. That's one thing we want to do. Say it wanted to create two players. And then what we want to do is, it doesn't just create two players, it creates a deck, let's say a new deck of cards, creates a new deck of cards, and that's all we basically said it's supposed to do, right? So deck equals deck dot new, and that's it. And we can do dot shuffle. So the new deck will give us a shuffled deck of cards, which I think is what we need to do. Yeah, because we'd have to initialize it. Yeah, that's what we're going to do to have a deal function. So we'll deal out cards each time. So right now, this is just a new game. So it makes the new game here. And in the game class, we're going to say def.dealRound. Right? So this is going to do deal out to the first player, to the second player, to the first player, to the second player, and give them the two cards each. Right? So we'll say, we will say at deck. This will say like at deck dot deal, and it'll be player one. And at deck dot deal, this is going to deal to player two. And to be like perfectly fair, I guess we could do it like this. So we could deal first card. Oops. And then we could deal the second card. There. So to deal these, we're going to have to do deck.deal each of them. Now let's look at the deal method. Oops. There is no deal method. So we have to deal. And we need a player class, is the other thing. So we need a new file for and we need a new player spec. Okay. So inside of the player spec, we just need to require player.rb, and then we need to do a describe game and end. Let's do that for now. Okay, so we've described it, got it all there. Now let's just make sure our tests still pass. We haven't written any new tests, so it shouldn't be a problem. Three tests all pass. And that's because we have empty tests. So let's go back to our game class again. So let's just talk this over for a second. So it makes a new game, and then it deals a round, right? Which deals out the cards to the players. So the players are going to make a new player each time. So it passes in Bill. So new game is what we're going to test, so game spec. So we have to say at poker dot. So player one, which isn't there. So we'll say expect. Oops. And we're going to call this guy game. Player one to equal. Well, it's just to not be nil, right? To be there. Let's just go check and see what that is. So let's do rspec. Dot should exist. So we'll do expect game.player. Dot should exist. So let's try that. And let's look back at that class. I think it's actually different than what I'm doing. I think it's actually game.player1. should exist. Let's check that out. No, it needs this expect syntax. So this is what it should look like. There. Dang it, that's still not liking that. Well, let's just try it first. What are we for job? I program for a job, bud. Program all the time. I own my own company, but that's closing down, and I'm looking to start up as a remote developer. I'm not a remote developer yet. I need to find a job first. But I have worked for 3 years as a software engineer. So we expected the two player to exist. So let's say that's the first player, and we want the second player to exist. And it creates a new deck of cards, so we want to expect that game.deck to exist. So let's go back to game. Now, inside each of these, it has like a bunch of stuff. So what we're going to need to say is adder accessor. Let's put in player 1 and player 2. And deck, because that's like the getter and setter method, so we need those. Trust me. So player 1, player 2 to exist. Let's run this test. So last time they were all passing. Now expected nil to exist, but it does not correspond to either exist or exists. At game.player1, which is nil. Ah, because we just made a new game. We didn't actually call the new game method. So what we could do instead is go into the game thing and call this initialize. And what that'll do is initialize it all up on the when we create a new object. So this will make it by default, I guess. And now I have to check these methods. I wonder if I can just describe game. Let's try that. Wrong number of arguments, 1 for 0 in initialize. Let's see that. So, initialize, grabs all these guys, player 1, player 2, deck, puts them inside of there, and now, let's just make this, I guess, maybe that's the error. One for zero. Let's just copy this. Go to here and do it. Test 1. That's interesting because game.rb5 in new. Game.rb line 5 in new. It's talking about this one, player new bill. Yeah. So that was kind of confusing. So it says, creates two players, failure, game.new, wrong number arguments 1 for 0. In this file, so game.rb new. So line 5, game.rb. So line 5 is calling the player class, and inside of there, there is no initialize method. See what I'm saying? There. Let's ruin the spec now. We got a different error. Okay. Expected a whole slew of cards. Let's see what's up here. Creates two players. Expect game player one is expected player name Bill to exist, but it does not respond to either exist or exists. So let's look inside our game spec. So got to exist is what we want. So expect game.player1 to exist. So maybe what we need to do is make a new game and just check to see what's there. So we'll say IRB load game.irb. Going to be lib slash game.rb, and I'll have to say g equals game.new player. So all these files aren't here, basically. That's frustrating. So what are we going to do? It's basically, let's read what the test said again. So it said, expect game player to exist. Expected player to exist, but it does not respond to either exist or exists. Okay. So let's try IRB again. And we'll load up lib slash player.rb because it's the simplest one. And we'll do p equals player.new. And you have to pass in the name, right? Bill. So that gives me the thing. So p.exist. I don't have anything that exists for player. Aha. So we need to say if it's not nil. So rspec see if object is not nil. Should is what it's showing here. Let's look at the RSpec documentation. It's not what I want. Three dot should not instance of number. Okay. Bob dot should. Let's see if there's a method list. So EQ is what we're using right now, right? exist is there. Should exist. Well, let's try that. Dot to, let's change that to dot should. And I think it's going to need, well, let's just try it like that first. Okay, if you need more of the backtrace, using should from the old should syntax without explicitly enabling syntax is deprecated. Use the new expect syntax or explicitly enable should instead. So it doesn't like that should. To I know what we can do. Let's just subvert this for now. Dot present. There we go. We can make this even better if we wanted to, but let's just for now to get it going. All right, so let's try this. Okay. Undefined method present for player. So game.player. So let's go back to here. Let's load up our lib/player.rb. And we'll say p equals player.new. And obviously I have to pass in the name, Bill. We'll say p.present. Why is that saying that? Why is that doing that? So let's say Ruby does object exists. Define, that's not really what we're looking for. Can we do dot nil? False. Okay, so let's just use .nil for now. So expect null to equal false. Is it nil? No. This is a bad way to do this, like as far as the syntax, but it will still work. All right, so let's go back to here, and we will do quit. There, they passed. Oh. Awesome. So, what did we just do? Let's go back and recap. So, in the game class, we've got a new game is created, and we expect a player to be there, a player 2 to be there, and a deck to be there. So, that's what we've just tested in this game spec. Okay? So, now we know that it creates 2 players, and it creates a new deck of cards. Okay? Awesome. Now we're going to make a new one of these guys. And we're going to say, describe the, what did I call it? Game? So describe the deal round. So game spec, describe deal round. So it deals 2 cards to each player. So, expect player1.cards.count to equal 2, and player2.cards.count to equal 2. So that's really all our method does right now, right? So deals, deck.deal player 1, deck.deal player 2, deck.deal player 1, deck.deal player 2. So in the deck class, the first thing we have to do is check our deal method. So what we'll have to do is get, we'll just make a index, let's say, equals rand, we'll say at rand of at fresh deck dot length. I think that will do it. Let's just double check that in IRB first. So we'll say A equals an array of a few things. Let's say like 1, 2, comma, 3, comma, 3, comma, 4, let's say. We'll say A dot length. It's going to be 4, so we'll say rand 4. Okay, so that's what we want. That's going to give us the right, this will give us an index of this array. So we'll say that card equals at fresh deck at whatever index, right? So that's, I'm just going to leave it as 2 lines, even though we could put it as 1. So this is the card that's dealt each time. And we're going to have to say above that, we'll have to remove that one as well, right? We'll have to get rid of that part of the array. So, I wonder if we can do A minus A comma 3. Fix them to array. So what we're going to have to do is find a way to remove the card from the deck. So we've dealt the card that's here. Don't you need an argument in the function to deal? I'm just going to get it to for the player. Let me check in there. So in the player class, I just have the name, and that's true. I have to have the name pass in each time that I set it, because that's the player's name that's there. But the player also has to have another one in here, which is going to be colon cards, right? Because at first, they're going to have at cards equals an empty array, right? So they have no cards at the first. So let's say def show cards, and they're going to have to show the cards that are there. So we'll say at cards dot each do pass in a card, and we'll say puts card. Card. And I think it's not just the actual card. We want to look at the card.display value. So it puts card.display value like that. So this will say, we'll print out at name, we'll say plus. So you put this as a double quote. Like that. So show cards will basically tell me what cards each player has. So now we can actually store the cards on the player class. So we need to test that in a second. So let's go to the player spec and just put a new test in there for that, just a stub for now. Oops. So we want something like this, basically. So copy that. Paste that. So before each, we'll just get rid of that, get rid of this, get rid of this. So describe player. So inside of there, we called it show cards. So in player spec, we'll say show cards like that, and that's what we need to test in a minute here. So let's get back to where we were. So back to the game. So the game has a deck and it's going to deal, so we're trying to deal the deck right now. So inside of here, we need to remove a card from this index. So I think the way to do that is, let's check the online documentation. Ruby remove card from array. Oops, remove element. Delete at. There we go. So we'll say at freshdeck.delete at index. Ooh, but that's going to remove the card before we actually show it. So what we need to do is do that at the end and return card. This is the card that was dealt. Okay, so let's talk about that for a second. So go back to the deck class, the deck spec. So if I shuffle, it does one thing. And now I need to make another block here. So let's do that. So now I'm going to do the deal method. So inside of the deal method, it basically has a fresh deck of cards at the start. So we already said that the cards are 52 when it starts out, right? So now what we need to do is a deck.shuffle, which will give us another fresh deck. Gives a new fresh deck of cards, and should deal a single card. So at first we expect it to be equal to 52. So we're just going to repeat this test. And then we're going to do at deck.deal. And then we're going to say we expect the cards to equal 51. Okay? So we'll deal it once. How am I passing each player's name to the deal function? I'm not 100% sure yet. I'm just sort of going off the fly here. So to the deal function? Oh, yeah, back in the game class. Because you're saying player 1 and player 2 to say, who do I deal these cards to, right? So we're going to actually change this. We're going to change this here. Because it has player 1, player 2, so we're going to say at player1.cards, and we're going to pipe in a new card, and it's just the result of deck.deal. That's what we're going to do. There. Does that make sense? Sweet. Yeah, I can see how that was a little confusing. At the first, you have to sort of add a lot of code at once, keep it all straight, and then you sort of go incrementally after that. So we're trying to set everything up in a big chunk here right now, but hopefully we'll be able to make that better as time goes on. So yeah, so now we've set up all our... This is how it's going to work. So basically the player.cards is going to get a card from the dealt card each time. Let's go back to the spec. Yeah. So inside of the deal method, it's going to shuffle the cards, deal a card, and it should deal a card out to one. Okay, so let's try that. Let's run our specs here. Okay, expect player1.cards count to equal 2. Oh, yeah. So this is in deal round, game.deal round. We forgot to add that test. So that is right here. So if it deals a round, right, so game.deal round, it should deal out all these rounds and expect the cards to equal whatever, right? So it expects the game.player1.cards.count to equal 2. Yeah, it gets equal 2. Okay, so the game is here and has a new game. So we didn't actually call the method. That's the problem. So we need to say at game dot, let's just make sure that's the way it goes. Deal round. So we deal the round, and then we expect the first one to have 2 cards, the second one to have 2 cards. And the error message we got was that there was zero cards there, right? So let's run it again. Undefined method deal for array. Okay, so I've messed up where I call it. Deck. So I say deck.deal. Oh, this is deck.new.shuffle. That's the problem. So shuffle returns an array, not the actual deck itself. So what we need to do is set this deck.new, right? And we'll say at deck.shuffle. Do you see the difference there? Any questions on why that was wrong? No, we're good? Okay, so we have a new deck, deck.shuffle, and now the deck.deal. Let's go in there. So deck.deal should deal a fresh card from here. So let's try that. Ta-da! So now we've dealt two cards. That's awesome. So maybe you're thinking to yourself, does this really work? Like, we've only shown the tests to see what's there, right? So let's go into the player spec for a second here. So show card. Let's see the cards the player has. So it should have two cards once a game is started. So what we need to do is set up this, like in the game, the game spec. So we're going to need a new game. And we're going to have to do at game.dealRound. So let's go into here. So that's going to go deal around and get all the player cards. So then we should be able to say up here. So we'll say at player one equals at game dot player one. So I guess the first thing to think is here, I'm testing the player class, but in my test I'm referencing game all the time. That probably means there's a design flaw in what I'm doing. Let me look at player.rb. So here it's kind of different. Show cards, right? That's all we have in here, and that's all we're really testing. So really the player spec should have like a card in here. So we say at player equals player dot new, say test. So there's a new test player. And inside of that, we're going to say let's have two cards, right? So we're going to say two dot times do, we're going to say at player dot cards, we're going to pipe in a card dot new and pass in the ace of spades. And that has to be in quotes. And instead of doing it two times, I'm just going to repeat it twice because it's faster. So it should have the ace of spades and ten of spades. So we should be able to do at player.showCards. So expect so it shouldn't be nil. If I show the cards, that result shouldn't be nil. So let's go into player show cards. So that puts out it prints out this stuff basically, right? Let's see what happens there. So we've saved it. Let's run the spec file. There it is. Test cards are the ace of spades and the ten of spades. So that has two cards that were there. So it printed out that buffer. So that kind of is a pain in the butt because now we have output that's happening in our test output, which we don't really want. We'd rather not have that there and just make sure that it's printing out this stuff. Like, we want to show the information, but that's it. Because it's going to run through the code, right? So it's going to put this out, put this out, put this out. I'm not sure how to do that right now. Yay, yeah! So anyway, there's the player's cards. So let's go through and make a class here. So just inside of this, the root directory, we're going to file called play.rb. I'll just call it play.rb so I don't have to type as much. So inside here I can write Ruby files. So I'm going to say like load lib/card. Let's load up all these guys. Instead of card, it's going to be deck.rb. This is going to be game.rb. And this is going to be player.rb. Okay? So first thing I'm going to do is say, will this be recorded? I think it is recorded automatically. So we'll say game equals game.new. That's the first thing we're going to happen in the game. And then we need to go to like the game spec class. So we need to deal round. So we'll say game.dealRound. So we dealt the round. And now we need to say game.player1.showCards. And game.player2.showCards. So we'll say puts here are the player cards. So above this we're gonna say puts a new round has started. Okay, so this is basically so I don't have to retype everything every time. So I want to deal a round and then show what each player's cards have. Coming from C, not so used to this, that's definitely true because C is not object oriented. So anyway, let's run this file and see if it works. It's called play.rb, so let's just do ls. There's play.rb, so we'll do ruby play.rb. Now let's search file card.rb. Ugh. It's probably not load, it's like require or something. What is OOP in a nutshell? Object-oriented programming is what that stands for, object-oriented programming. It means that you have objects that you're working with. So instead of just running things like A equals A plus 1 and, you know, just statements that are over and over or calling functions, you actually have a class which is like an object. So in our case, what we have is like the deck class, for instance. So this class deck means that you can have like multiple decks. You make new decks every time, and as you make those new decks, they have properties on them and functions and methods, but they're each treated like their own individual instance in memory. That's what object-oriented programming is in a nutshell, I guess. Does that help you, Thomas? Might be a lag. I'm just going to keep going. So play.rb. So let's see what the error was there. Can I search file lib/card.rb? Well, F. Let's just try to do it this way. And let's just call some game. Let's see how I did in my other class. Load. I kind of thought that's what I did. Okay, player. Okay, I got it that time. Cool. So let's make a new one here. Okay, so player.rb. There's that one, so let's load up again. Deck. So I don't know why this didn't work before, but it seems to be working now. Card.rb. Card.rb. It's probably because deck requires it. Let's try this first. So, that's a good question. I think load basically puts the contents of the file above, where require uses them, like if it's a module, you need to require a module versus like just loading the file. I think load is what we're looking for in this situation. Because see here it says require card.rb. So every new game class, you assign them to variables. That's how you keep track of where everything is. We're going to do that in just a second. Let's try load. Oh, no, that's what it is. Require lib slash card.rb. Let's try that. Again with the require thing. What's that? Yep. All right, I'll see you in a bit. Love you. So why is this killing me? So we're in decks, we can require card.rb, that's fine. But inside of here, this deck file doesn't like that. I think let's just do some Googling here and see what the differences require and load. Require searches for the library in all the defined search paths and also pens .rb or .so to the file name you enter. It also makes sure the library is only included once. Ooh. So if your application requires library A and B, and library B requires library A, you would be loaded only once. With load, you need to add the full name of the library and get it loaded every time you call load, even when it's already in memory. Let's go to... So why doesn't this load work? That's the main question, right? So like load up a file. So we're loading the file card.rb so we can get this card new. So let's run the spec class. So all the specs pass. When I run it to play it, I cannot load such file card.rb. Deck.rb. So why can't I load that file there? Let's try require. I say require, it says cannot load such file. So I guess they're doing the same thing, just one does it a little smarter than the other one. Cannot load such file card.rb. Oh, I wonder if it has to be... No? /card.rb. Let's see if that still passes the spec. No, it doesn't. It needs to be card.rb. Let's have a look at this error. Require relative. Okay, let's try that. Was it to be... sort. Oh, you're right! Thank you, Sam! Oh, I did not know about that method. That is so awesome. A plus. Thumbs up. Great job. There. Isn't that amazing? Sweet. So now we have Bill's cards and Laura's cards. It shows out the stuff. That's awesome. So we run the player.rb file. It gives the seven of hearts, the three of diamonds, the five of spades, the queen of diamonds out to the people. So let's just make it a little bit nicer in play.rb. And we're just going to... That was awesome, man. So we'll do puts, and we're just going to put a blank string so that when we run this guy, it'll just... The only reason is to divide it up. Oh, and I did... I want to put this between here. So I want to run this. There it is. So I've got Bill's cards and Laura's cards. So here are the player cards, Bill cards, Laura cards. Boom. Okay. So there's the player's cards, Bill's cards, and Laura's cards. I wonder if we can actually color this to make it a different color. That'd be kind of cool, wouldn't it? And we're just here to fun program, so why not? So let's do Rails puts with color. So it's not as nice as it could be. What if we do... Oh, there we go. So, cyan is 36. Let's go to, like, yellow, 33. So, importing tags... So it needs to have an E and then a 31. Huh. Let's just copy this and see if that works. What is going on here? What? Oh, it's because I'm like deep within the stack now. Yeah, it's I need to cancel out of this. Bum, 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 bum. There we go. So let's run IRB again. Puts. And we're just gonna pass in foo first. There it is. And now we need to pass in this string. Did not like it. So I see E0. That doesn't look like it's working very well. Oh, it's a double quotes thing. Let's try this. Again, I'm in too deep in the stack. Okay. So so it doesn't take that for me for some reason. I can't get the colors. But anyway, who cares? Let's get back down to here. Oh, I meant to tell you, there's some cool things. This website, Confreaks, is an amazing website to look at Ruby stuff, but it's more than just Ruby. It's like conferences all over the place. Like Robert Martin or Uncle Bob is there doing stuff. Like there's tons and tons of free conference videos. They're wicked. You should check it out. The other one that's awesome is called bentobox.io. And it has like fundamentals. You click on HTML. All right, Sam. I'll try it your way. So we'll say... And the color code was 31 last time. Excuse me. No, no dice. Anyway, Bento Box shows you a bunch of things. You can click on like Dash or Code Academy, and it shows you all the things to be a great web developer, what you'd need. So yeah, and my stuff on, I have a Twitter account. You should follow me on that if you want to get more notifications when we'll do this again to have a little more fun. So it's at O'Donnell Carl, O-D-O-N-N-E-L-C-R-L. So if you could follow me on there, that'd be great. So that is at O-D-O-N-N-E-L-C-A-R-L, like that. So if you could follow me on Twitter, that would be sweet. I'd really appreciate it. Okay, so next thing is what? Ruby play.rb, so that gave us our cards, and every time it's giving new cards, which is really cool. So that's pretty friggin' sweet. Have we tested everything we need to test? So the card spec has nothing inside of it. Don't worry about it. So the card spec has nothing inside of it, so we need to check the value of the cards. I need to basically go through and check this value, which we're going to do in a minute here. Because now we need to do a class that basically evaluates. I'm not going to end it now. No, I've got another like 45 minutes probably. So I've got to make a class that decides who's the winner in these two hands, right? Because, oh, something else we totally forgot to do. The game has to deal a round, right? And then it has to deal middle cards. I'm just going to call them middle cards. What are they called? Like the turn, the river, all these things. Like the five cards in the middle, right? So we'll say deal middle cards. So the game has a deck of cards. It also has middle cards. And instead of here, we're just going to say at deck equals, oh, at middle cards. So we'll say at middle cards equals an array. So we'll just put an empty array. And then we'll say at middle cards, and we're going to pipe in at deck.deal. So I normally have to do this like 5 times, right? I don't really like that. Now we have a reason to make a multiple deal, you know what I mean? Like deal 2 to each person. But we're going to leave it like this for now. So inside of the game class, we need to check that the middle cards are populated. So let's go into the game spec. Make a new test here. And what we'll do now is, what do I call it? Deal middle cards. So inside of here, instead of deal round, we're going to then deal the middle cards. So we're going to deal around. Then we're going to do at game.deal. Oops. Deal the middle cards and expect the game dot middle cards dot count, because it's not anything else, it's different now, so equal 5, right? Let's run our specs, make sure it passes. Yep, it does, so that's great. So that method is confirmed, it deals out 5 cards. And now we need to go to, well, there's our middle cards, right? So game, so there's our 5 middle cards dealt out. And now we need to print out what the middle cards are. So we're going to have a method in here to say show middle cards. And it's going to say at middle cards.each do card. This is exactly what we wrote before. We're just, you know, doubling up what we did basically. And we're going to say puts card dot display value. Say puts the middle IDDLE like that. So in our play class, it's going to show the player cards, and then it's going to do game.dealMiddleCards, and then it's going to do puts. Again, we're showing a blank. Oh, I hate doing that. I hate putting these blanks everywhere. We'll fix that in a minute. So we'll say puts game.show middle cards. There we go. So now we just have to test our game spec. So it dealt the middle cards, and now the show should still be working. So it prints out the middle cards. Deal middle cards, and we'll say at, so I'll say at game dot show middle cards dot nil is equal false. So let's run the test. There it is. So it printed out the middle cards. There's the 5 of them. The middle cards are do-do-do-do-do, like that. Okay, so let's go back to here. And now what we need to do is, if we play the game, we should show the middle cards as well, right? Which should be fine. So let's go back to the terminal and run the play.rb. Ah, it didn't show the display values. That's interesting. So it printed out the 5 cards. Oh, look, there's the five cards. And then it printed out the five cards, the actual glasses. Why did it do that? So it printed out all the display values. So the middle cards are, there's the display values of each. And then... why is it doing that? Deal middle cards. Just adds to the array. Show middle cards runs the display value. Just put a debug in here, so let's say puts end. I'll rerun this. Oh, it's because it was the result of the method that was being printed. So you see it wrote end there? It basically got rid of all these things that were the card objects, because that's what was just being spit out by default in that method. I'm not 100% sure why that is, though. Because we're not, like, printing that again. So, yeah, I'm not really 100% sure why that is. So what we're going to do is just put nil at the end. Because it's just a show method, right? So let's try that. There it is. So Bill has the cards, Laura has the cards, and the middle cards are those ones, and it should never be the same, you know? They should never be duplicates that are there. Okay. Any questions up to that point? Let's just go back and see if there's any questions. No, we're good there. So, any other questions you want to ask before I continue forward? I'll give you a second to answer while I look at the Twitter feeds and stuff. And then we'll go to make sure there's nothing on learning programming. It's the Queen of Hearts. Yeah, Q just stands for Queen of Hearts. Okay. Writing a lot of redundant code. One of the Ruby's tenets is that you always write dry code, don't improve yourself. For example, cards equals deck.new. So let's look at this, what he says. So, writing a lot of redundant code. So, instead of saying like card.new, I should write something like this. So, I've never really talked about this. So, card.suits.collect do suit, card.values collect do, and it goes through and basically makes a new one for each one. So, it says suit and value. So, yeah, it just basically iterates through all those ones, stack, deck, dot, flatten. Yeah, that's definitely true. We could absolutely do that. Makes, you know, little difference. I copied it from another section, so that was the reason that I did that. We could easily iterate through them, though. But let's put, this guy wants to do some review, so let's do it. So let's say git init, git add dot, so we'll add all the files, git commit -am, say poker first commit. Now we have to go to GitHub, repositories. Let's make a new repository. Call this poker. And make it public. And we'll say this guy. And I'll say git push dash f origin master. There. So then we should go into here and see all the files. Now you can comment on those if he wants to. Ask anybody else. Put pull requests, reviews, or change things up, whatever you'd like to do. I'm here to improve as well, right? So we'll go here. So, I like what he's saying here. Let's just go through it and do it, because I think what he's saying is correct, especially for this case. So, let's go into deck. The first thing he says, instead of making a fresh deck equal this, what we should really do is do something like this. So, we'll just get this new deck, and let's get this over here, because that's probably the worst place I was repeating myself. So, we'll say card.suits. So let's go into card. The card is actually just a single card object. It's the deck that has the suits, I would say. So let's say deck dot, I don't like this double syntax. So let's say suits. I don't really like that either to be capitalized, but that's probably because it's a constant. Let's check. I have a check inside of in here. Constant class C1. Yeah, that's why he's saying that. And it's capitals, even though it's not capitals there. So he's right. Let's go up here and say suits equals, we'll do an array of clubs, hearts, diamonds, spades. And it's wanting me to put that percent W thing in front of it. There. So that's my new deck suits. And let's do the values below that. So we'll say percent W. We'll say the values are A, comma, 2, 3, 4. This is why I basically copy pasted it in the first place. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Jack, Queen, Queen, King. So that should give me stacked up dot flatten. So let's try it. stackduck.flatten. So if I do a shuffle on here, it should give me an output of the deck. So let's do IRB. Say load. And we'll say D equals deck.new. Oops, capital D. And then we'll say D.shuffle. I'm going to search constant deck suits. It's probably because I'm not defining them properly. Let's see. Outside the class. So. Constant name is capitals, I guess. Okay. So we'll say suits. Oh, that's it too. We did it. Values. And now let's go back to here and load it up again. Make a new deck and shuffle. Boom. Is that too many cards? Looks like too many cards. So we'll say underscore dot count. 52. He was right. Excellent observation. Bills to me. Which I don't think is actually in our chat, but that's cool. So basically, we can now get rid of this garbage. Which is great. And fresh deck, there's no way to make like a fresh deck. So you could actually make this initialize. So every time you make a deck object, it just gives you the right decks. And deck.cards. So deck is an array of cards. I think I still like to have. Well, let's say cards. And then down here we're going to say there. So I don't need this method anymore. And I don't need this method anymore. There, that's probably better, right? So let's make sure our specs all pass. Fails. So, deck shuffle should have a fresh deck of 52 cards. Oh yeah, that's right. Now we just have initialize, right? So on a new deck, so we need to go to the deck spec. And so just on initialize, so we'll say expect deck.cards.count equal 52. So that's the first one. So if we don't need this either. So we don't need to shuffle it every time. It's always a new deck, just like at a casino. So I know I meant to shuffle for deck gamespec.rb. Where is that? Game.rb line 8. So we don't need to shuffle these anymore. The new deck has already the good cards in it. There's no reason to shuffle again afterwards, so he is definitely right. Sweet! Down to one failure. So this is a little weird. So, middle cards prints out the middle cards. Fail, expect to be false. Got true. So that is in Game spec 39. So this is dealing a new card each time, and puts the card.display value. That's interesting. Wonder why that didn't work. Let's go back to here. So the middle cards are diamonds 8, hearts 4, spades A. So let's go back to the card, because it's card.display value, right? Number plus suit. Suit, number. Number, suit. Number, suit. So let's go back into the game deck, maybe. Ah, it should be value. In fact, let's make it, yeah, in suit. And it's actually, this is actually number in the context that we've written before. So now let's go back and run the tests. Expected false got true. So let's load up the game. So that gives me the Jack of Clubs, the Seven of Diamonds, the Ace of Hearts. Okay. So display value is giving me a comma between each one. I don't really like how that's formatted, but we can check that later. It's not a huge deal. Warning, top level constant suits referenced by deck, suits, card, numbers. It's because these have to be out of here and go inside the class, I believe. Nope. Class foo, constant name. Anyway, back to here. So, gives us the cards. Next time, we'll go through and actually try to evaluate the hands and see which ones are the best and get the output a little nicer and that type of thing. But I'm basically spent right now. Any other quick questions before I go? Okay, thanks a lot.